My name is Margarita Delgado. I'm Deputy Governor in Banco de España. Nowadays, the most, disruptive element that we are facing in Europe, probably in almost all the jurisdictions, is the inflation, both advanced and emerging economies. So we are already observing a trend since, mid-2021, as a consequence of the value chain disruptions and commodity and energy spikes. But after this first initial wave, this has been even fueled by the invasion of Ukraine. So the impact in energy prices and other kind of commodities is huge. Of course, I mean, these unexpected events haven't been seen for ages and decades, and we need a kind of reaction in a kind of a duly balanced approach. So this inflation is triggering a change in monetary policy, but in my view, although the effects will be twofold. First, probably for most banks that are well positioned to interest rates hikes, they will get further net interest income. But on the other hand, of course, due to tightening the financial conditions, the companies that are rather leveraged will be, affected. So it will be crucial to observe these two elements. I think everything will depend on the speed and gradualism and flexibility of the monetary policy decisions. We are really experiencing a business transformation, and I think this is really exciting in many economic sectors. Of course, more precisely in the financial sector, I mean, digitalization is changing everything. It was amazing, or it is amazing, how this mature and traditional sector can be transformed. In Spain, we passed a law in November 2020, the so-called Sandbox law, and this has really enhanced and promoted new projects from biometrics to other kind of businesses, or digital identification, or even the payment online and on real time of the different bills and the cash management. So since the law was approved, we received a kind of almost 70 projects. Not all of them passed the first, trimmer. But we have analyzed like 18 projects in the first wave and 10 projects in the second wave. And we are now in the third round of projects. So we are really confident that this will trigger again an innovation in the financial sector.